I like garlic a lot, but there's one thing I usually avoid when I see it on a restaurant table, and that's garlic oil that's been clearly sitting there for quite some while. Not because garlic is bad, it's quite the opposite. Garlic is antimicrobial, it kills bacteria. But garlic in oil is one of those cases where food safety can go wrong a little bit. So there are two parts of this video. First, I will explain the antimicrobial properties of garlic, and then I want to give you some specific advice on that garlic oil. So let me start with the good part. Garlic contains an antimicrobial substance called allicin. Now, but allicin is not present in an intact garlic clove. It only forms when you cut or when you crush the garlic, because as soon as you damage the cells, a chemical reaction starts and then allicin is produced. And this is also why simply throwing whole cloves into the food does very little to kill bacteria. You need to crush or chop the garlic first for the reaction to begin. Allicin itself is unstable, but it quickly turns into other sulfur-containing compounds that gives garlic its characteristic smell and flavor. So the antimicrobial activity, the smell and the taste, they are all closely connected. Garlic has therefore been used in food preservation, for example, when sausages like salami are coated with garlic. And this also explains two common cooking tips. First, it makes sense to let crushed garlic sit for a while, a few minutes before heating it, because the reaction needs some time. And second, if you heat the garlic very strongly for a long time, then those antimicrobial compounds, they also break down. So garlic works best when it's crushed first and added later rather than fried hard from the very beginning. And that said, garlic is not a true food preservative. A food can, of course, still spoil, and you still have to be careful. Now, I'm able to show this to you visually as well, because I've sliced some garlic into thin sections and I put them into petri dishes with bacteria. And then you can see a clear ring around the garlic. It's a so-called the zone of inhibition, because bacteria do not grow close to the garlic. And if the garlic has been boiled first, well, then the effect is naturally much weaker or completely gone. And this shows that only fresh garlic has its antimicrobial properties. And now comes the less pleasant part, because garlic can also carry spores of the bacterium Clostridium botulinum, and the bacterium that produces the botulism toxin. And these spores are extremely resistant, and the garlic's antimicrobial compounds, they are not reliably able to kill them. And the real danger appears when garlic is put into the oil. And the oil blocks the oxygen, and under the low oxygen conditions, the bacteria can grow and produce the toxin if the temperature and the acidity allow it. And this is also why homemade garlic in oil needs a special care, because only make it in small amounts, never store it at room temperature, keep it refrigerated, and treat it as short-lived. And a general guideline is to discard the homemade garlic oil after a few days in the fridge. And even a safer option is to freeze it in small portion and only thaw up those that you are actually going to use. Botulism bacteria do not like acidic environments, so soaking the garlic in lemon juice before adding the oil can reduce the risk, but this is also just an additional safety barrier and not a guarantee that it will work. Commercial garlic oils are usually acidified and processed specifically to control this risk of botulism. Luckily, botulism caused by garlic stored in oil is quite rare, but it has been documented, and for this reason, garlic in oil preparations are monitored by food safety authorities. So garlic, it really is antimicrobial, and you can clearly show that in the lab as well. But when garlic is stored in oil the wrong way, then biology flips the whole situation completely. Thank you for watching. I wish you all the best. I'm Oliver, and as always, happy microbe hunting, and hope to see you in the next video. Bye bye.